I'm Tracy Metro with The Craft Kitchens. Brunch is one of my favorite times to entertain. And because it's a little bit breakfast and a little bit lunch, the menu can be a bit confusing, so stick around. I'm having a classic brunch this afternoon, and you're invited. I've decided to use my dining room table as a buffet for a more casual feel. And since it's brunch, I'm serving a beautiful warm broccoli and cheddar quiche. This is so delicious, and believe it or not, it's really easy to make. Here's how you do it. To make it, you whisk your eggs first, then add a little Miracle Whip and milk, mix it all together, then add your sauteed broccoli and mushrooms. Then comes the ooey gooey part, which is the shredded sharp cheddar cheese. You just pop it in the oven and bake it until the center of the quiche is set and the top is a gorgeous golden brown. For a brunch like this, I like to offer two main dishes. So here we have the perfect complement to our quiche, which is a beautiful layered Cobb salad. Once again, not hard at all to make. You just place your lettuce on the bottom, then cherry tomatoes cut in half, chopped cooked chicken, some chopped avocado, and a little bit of red onion. Then comes the really good stuff. Spoon on your favorite creamy dressing. Now I'm using ranch dressing, and then add some shredded cheddar cheese and bacon. And just to be sure that everyone gets their favorite kind of cheese in this brunch, I'm serving a gorgeous sauteed asparagus and pepper and onion dish that has some shredded Parmesan on top. Now, what would brunch be without an assortment of pastries and other goodies? We have bagels over here with three different kinds of cream cheeses to choose from. We also have this beautiful sour cream coffee cake right here. And have you ever thought of making your very own Danish pastries? Well, it's really simple. You start with refrigerated crescent rolls, push together the perforated edges, spread on some Neufchâtel cheese mixed with just a bit of sugar, add some blueberries, and then you fold them by bringing the corners together, and then bake. Now, doesn't that look like it came from the bakery? Since coffee can go fast at a brunch, I always like to keep another pot brewing in the kitchen. I also give my guests plenty of little treats for their coffee, like cinnamon and brown sugar, and a few different types of milk and cream. Now for drinks, we have mimosas with four different kinds of juices. And I have some club soda for those who want the fizz, but not the alcohol with their juice. Above all, have fun with your brunch. Look for all of these recipes and lots more at Houdini. I'm Tracy Metro from the Craft Kitchens for Houdini, and I am all ready for my guests. Oh, and here they are.